As you can tell, it's kind of dusty around here. We're going through the Dust Bowl right now. And, well, during the Dust Bowl, there were a lot of people that talked about it and wrote about it. But one of the people that wrote about the Dust Bowl was this man named Woody Guthrie. And some years after the Dust Bowl, he put together this album called the Dust Bowl Ballads, which many people from Oklahoma are familiar with. And so this is a short little introduction to talk about Woody Guthrie and the history of Woody Guthrie's life. And he did a lot more than just writing about the Dust Bowl. So let's let's find out a little bit more about Woody Guthrie.
John Steinbeck said this about Woody Guthrie. He is just a voice and a guitar. He sings the songs of a people, and I suspect that he is, in a way, that people. Harsh-voiced and nasal, his guitar hanging like a tire iron on a rusty rim. There is nothing sweet about Woody. There is nothing sweet about the songs he sings. But there is something more important for those who still listen. There is the will of the people to endure and fight against oppression. I think we call this the American spirit. When Woody was 19 years old, he moved to Texas, and he started becoming more involved in music. He said, "We played for rodeos, centennials, and carnivals, parades, fairs, just bust-down parties, and played several nights and days a week just to hear our own boards rattle and our strings roar around in the wind. It was long in these days I commenced singing. I guess it was singing." During the Great Depression, Woody, like hundreds of other Dust Bowl refugees, hit Route 66 and along also was looking for a way to support his family who remained back in Pampa, Texas. He was moneyless and hungry, and he hitchhiked and rode freight trains and even walked his way to California, taking whatever small jobs he could in exchange for bed and boarding. Woody painted signs and played guitar and sang in saloons along the way, developing a love for traveling the open road. A lifelong habit he would often repeat.
Here I am by the hobo campfire, and Woody and I are gonna sing a song that he wrote. It's called the Dust Bowl Blues. We'll just do one little part of it. Well, I just blowed in and I got them Dust Bowl Blues. Well, I just blowed in and I got them Dust Bowl Blues. And I blow right in, and I blow right back again. Well, I had me a woman, she was young and sweet. Oh, yes, she was, Woody. Oh, I had me a woman, she was young and sweet. But you know what happened? Oh, the dust storm came and bed her 1,600 feet. That's one of the reasons why people liked your music, Woody. Had some humor to it that we could relate to, and we understood what it meant by having so much dust, felt like we were buried. Thanks a lot, Woody.
Eventually moved to California and got a job at a radio station singing old-time traditional songs as well as some of his own original material. It was at this time Woody began to attract widespread public attention, especially from the thousands of relocated Okies gathered in migrant camps. They were living in makeshift cardboard and tent shelters. Woody's program provided entertainment and had a nostalgic sense of the home life they'd left behind. And despite their desperate circumstances, he strongly identified with his audience, and he even adapted to an outsider status along with them. Woody moved to New York, and it was then that he recorded the Dust Bowl Ballads for RCA Victor, his first album of original songs. He also joined a group of singers and formed the Almanacs, and this group would help create folk music into a popular and commercial success. Woody said that music was a powerful way to communicate. He said, "One of the mainest ways is by singing. You drop the word folk and just call it real, honest-to-God American singing. No matter who makes it up, no matter who sings it, and who don't. If it talks the lingo of the people, it's a cinch to catch on, and it will be sung here and yonder for a long time after you cashed in your chips. Woody was paid to compose some songs about the Grand Coulee Dam project, and while he was there, he wrote the Grand Coulee Dam, Roll On Columbia, and The Biggest Thing That Man Has Done.
There's a great and peaceful river in a land that's fair to see, where the Douglas fir tree whispers to the snow-capped mountain breeze. Where the cliffs are solid granite and the valley's always green, this is just as close to heaven as my traveling feet have been. Roll, Columbia, won't you roll, roll, roll. Roll, Columbia, won't you roll, roll, roll. I climb the rocky canyon where the Columbia River rolls. Seen the salmon leaping, the rapids and the falls. The big Grand Coulee Dam in the state of Washington is just about the biggest thing that man has ever done. Three times the size of Boulder or the highest pyramid makes the Tower of Babel a plaything for a kid. From the rising of the river to the setting of the sun, the coulee is the biggest thing that man had ever done. I'd better quit my talking, cause I told you all I know. But please remember, partner, wherever you may go, I've been from here to yonder, I've been from sun to sun. Coulee Dam's the biggest thing that man has ever done.
The subjects of Woody's songs were not just always political or geographic, but rather he sometimes wrote songs for kids. He once said, "Watch the kids, do like they do, act like they act, yell like they yell, dance the way you see them dance, sing like they sing, work and rest the way the kids do. You'll be healthier, you'll feel wealthier, you'll talk wiser, you'll go higher and do better and live here amongst us if you just only jump in here and swim around in the songs and do like the kids do. I don't want the kids to be grown-ups, I want to see the grown folks be kids." Woody Guthrie paved the way for Bob Dylan and Bruce Springsteen and a host of other folk and rock musicians who were moved by their conscience to share experiences and voice opinions in a forthright manner. Guthrie wrote hundreds of songs, including such classics as "This Land Is Your Land," "So Long, It's Been Good to Know You," "Grand Coulee Dam," "I Ain't Got No Home," and "Dust Bowl Refugees."
I'm gonna break my speed, fill around. I'm gonna break.